Lab11 DNS Rebinding Attack. We will complete all tasks described in the lab manual. Okay, here is the lab setup. We have practiced Docker. So for 10 times in 10 labs throughout this semester. So you are supposed to be very familiar with how to set up the lab environment. In this lab, we are going to attack IoT device behind the firewall or in a local area network. Please read this manual carefully by yourself as a refresh on the contents we discussed during the lecture. In this lab, we are going to set IoT is a thermostat. It controls the temperature of a room. We will set the temperature to a dangerous number. To set this temperature, two APIs are needed. One is a password, the other one is the temperature. To set the temperature, we need the password. The password is just used to defeat the cross-site request forgery CSRF attack. Without this protection, a simple CSRF attack is sufficient. You all know how to launch CSRF attack from the course we done last semester. So here is the lab environment setup. We have two networks, the home network protected by a firewall in the router. The user machine is our version. The IoT server located in the home network and the user machine, so we can set its temperature. And on the outside, there is an attacker controls name server and the web server. The malicious code or host on the web server. And the attacker try to exercise the try to control or set the temperature through the IoT server. The attacker finds tricks using social engineering to lure the user to access the attacker's server. The malicious code will be based on the party, the open with the password server. So when the attacker try to use his or her network to prevent the server. To the IoT's IP address. The same origin policy will fit the detection. Continuous setup. Scroll down. Machine. Okay, let's bring up all of the containers. Here are the containers. Attack name server, attack web server, LT server, local DNS server, and the loader. First, we are asked to reduce Firefox DNS cache time. DNS cache time. Here, the DNS cache expression. What is set up to 0 by default? It's 60. Once you are done, once you change it to 0, please restart your Firefox. Since I already did it, I will not restart my Firefox. So please remember after your the modification, please restart your Firefox. Next, change the etc host. So we assign the FQTN to the LT's IP address, LT server's IP address, so we can access with this FQTN. With the geditor, we need a sudo host. Okay, please check these entries carefully. Here is a seed lt32.com. You may have or you may not. If you have, check the IP address. It looks right. If you don't have, just copy this line and paste here. The notation is you may have an IP address. For the attacker, say to FQTN, please remember comment out this part. I emphasize twice. Please remember comment out your attack say2.com. Use a pound key, or you just delete this line. If you don't have this line, it's good. For you, if you have comment out or delete it, that one and save it. Step 3. Now we can access this LT seed LT32 with this name. Wait a moment. Yes, all our containers are brought up. So now we can access it. The thermometer. That is a temperature, a nice temperature, 20 degrees. So you can move this slide to change the temperature. The local DNS server. Here we will set our user virtual machine to use this particular local DNS server. By change the setting inside this file, okay, I want to add the line. So please remember as I you don't have. We need to update our resolver. Okay, we complete all the setup. Now we are going to test the lab setup with the dig command to find the IP addresses of the attack. Say tool.com is name server. We should be able to get these two IP addresses. Sorry. Right, you see the IP address 10.9.0.180 for the attacker for its name server. Okay, this is right. So if you do not get this, your lab environment is not set up correctly. So currently my lab is set up correctly. Now we can test the attacker's website. It's this one. Please provide a screenshot in your lab report. Okay, here is a screenshot attack's website. Attack countdown from 10 to 0. It alone automatic attack. You're still talking to me, the attack. You need to talk to the IoT device. Okay, let's close it. Now, how do I know it's talked to the attack to the IoT device? You need to find the IP address of this website. So, to find the IP address of a website, we need a web developer network. In this network, reload it. Okay, reload. The attack set tool on the right side. You can see its IP address. I didn't see its IP address here. access to the password. It's trying to get the password inside the home network, and it cannot do that. You see the whole file with the error. You check the errors here. The password is undefined. Launch the attack. Fail. Still talking to the attacker's web server. What I want to find is the IP address for the website you are talking to. It chooses a thermometer. You remember that shortcut? Ctrl Shift K. Okay, every second is try to get the temperature, which means this interface is refreshed every second. Here again, I didn't see the IP address. Okay, here it is. Choose one and find the IP address. Right, you see there's a home network, the IP address for the IoT device. What is attacker? We may try to have a look whether we can find the IP address to show up. The root. Okay, anyway, we didn't find it. We will see another web page where we can find it. We wanted to find the IP address for the thermometer, and it's right. Launch the attack on the IoT device. Understanding the same origin policy protection. Here you are asked to open these web links. We already opened this C.LTC2 here, thermometer here. Now, for the second one, this web page is used to change the temperature. Right here, change temperature. Counter is 25 degrees. You click here. Pay attention from the same website, the C.LTC2. Click change, come to see the thermometer 99 centigrade. So it worked, right? And we can check the console what it says. Here they'll still refresh 1 second at a time. Now to change the temperature, you can also get a response from the server. You can change it again to see what you get. Go back, click change. Then you see it get a password. That password is gotten. And got a response from the server. Then you check the temperature. It's changed to 99 centigrade. Now, the attacker's malicious website, if the attacker want to change the password, here this attacker's web page uses to change the password. It's identical to the user's LT web page to change the temperature. Now the temperature is a dangerous temperature set by the user. Let's change it to another one, to a nice temperature. Then the attacker try to change the temperature. Please bring up your web console, Ctrl Shift K. Now we click, basically you can refresh to see where it's from. Here, find the network. this web page is IP address. Didn't see the web page. Still didn't see the IP address. Alright, now let's click and see from the console what you will get. Click, we get an error. Request blocked. Cross orange request because we try to set the temperature in the home network. It says the same origin or is disallowed. It try to read the seed ltc2.com password. So there's an error. The network could always find the IP address didn't show up here. Okay, we wanted to see that is a failure, right? It is an error, it failed. And you see the temperature is still 25 centigrade. So without further techniques, this attack cannot succeed. As I said, these two web pages, they are identical. From the home network, the seed LTC tool, it can be changed. From the attacker, it cannot be changed. Here, you use the web console to find the error. We already see that error. Now, we are going to defeat the same origin policy protection with the DNS rebinding attack. We want to change the IP address of this attack, c2.com. To bind to that LT device's IP address, then actually those attacking code will be run without violating the SOP policy. That's the principle. First, we need to modify the JavaScript code. Here, JavaScript code. Inside the attack machine, here is inside the attacker's web server. We need to change the code. At the beginning, it tried to use CSRF. It tried to send a request to this web server, but the response cannot go back to the attacker's machine because of SIP SOP policy. Now let's open server console for this. For this continuous, here we open a 1, 2, 3. Attacker name server, attacker web server, local DNS, so let's open it like this, follow this order, attacker name server. The LT, oh, the attacker's web server. It is a attacker's name server. local DNS server. To change the code in the attacker's web server under this folder. That is a nano editor. So it asks to change the first line. This line. Let's just comment out. Attacker setup.com. Go to save it. Control R, press under Control X. Quit. Okay, now it's changed to this attack setup.com. After making the change, restart the attacker's web server container and refresh the change temperature web page again to see what happened. We need to restart to the container. Ctrl D. Docker container. You may use its ID or its name, it's up to you. Okay, this website now. From attackers, change web page. You may refresh. Refresh this one. We want to find the change.js to see its code. Open the debugger. Right, you see it's updated. Attacker.com. So this looks good. Now, here we click set the temperature again to see what happened. It's a good idea, may you clean this output. Currently, the temperature is 25 degrees. Now we want to click change. Here the you see the arrow. The password is undefined. That is a for file method not allowed. So it's different from the previous arrow. The previous arrow is SOP policy violated, but now this time is a for file. You may check what does a for file mean. I put some linkers. Put some linkers here. Reference link. or you just Google it to find quickly. The website, the code is executed on the user's machine. However, the password is not gotten because it communicated with a text to a website. On that website, there is no password. The password cannot be gotten. The password in the LT. Okay, now we are going to conduct the DNS rebinding work inside the attacker's name server and try to modify the zone attack set to .com. We need to change the TTL time to a short number, currently it's 1000 seconds. After you modify the attack set to www.attackset2.com with IP address to the IoT device IP address, you need to reload this zone. And on the local DNS server, it cached the IP address currently for our attack set to talk. We need to fix it because its time is 1000 seconds. This local DNS server. Let's go to the attacker's name server first. We use nano to edit that zone attack setto.com. Oops. And you see the TTL is 3 days, so it's much longer than the number here. Here is 1000 seconds, but in the code is 3 days, so let's change it just to 2 seconds. Well, 1 second is up to you. I change it to a small number. Here you see the name server and the web server. I would like to copy this line. Now, to bind the IoT IP address. The IoT IP address is this one. Paste here. Okay, we need to comment out the one. We want to rebind, right? Rebind our attack setto.com, the website, to the IoTs. On your own, press enter, save it. Then we need a load. Reload attack setto.com. Okay, the zone reloaded. We need to clean the cache in the local DNS server, the previous IP address or NDC. We can only do that once because at the beginning the cache for 3 days. Okay, now it's flushed. flushed on the user machine, you can dig this AS the www taxi2.com to find its IP address. Say2.com. Attacker. Right now you see it's bound to the LT device. Launch the attacker. Go to the here. We need to refresh the attack02.com channel. Refresh it. You can see where it's from. Oops, I didn't see the IP address. We click to see when we can find the IP address. You can also open the console, clean the logger. Clean the temperature is 88. So here is 99. Let's change the temperature to a good temperature. Click. Cross orange request blocked. Same orange policy disallowed. So why we still get this error? Now the reason is the name is attack setup, but the IP address is the LT's IP address. So the step we run this attack is not right. Before we refresh it, we need the old attacker's IP address. After the user accessed the change web page, then we rebind the IP address, because once the user accessed the web page, the code is downloaded on the user machine. After that, before we click, we need to rebind. So that's a step we need to do it. So let's clean the error. In the attacker's machine, the name server is 90 before the attack. We need to bind to the attacker's machine. Delete. Ctrl O, press Enter, Ctrl X, save it, and then reload. Please remember, reload the zone. Change it. Refresh. Refresh it. This time it's bind to the attack machine, right? Here, and you click this arrow. Click that arrow, see the gaps. So this is the attacker's machine. Now, the code is on the user machine now. It's downloaded to the user machine now. Before we click that button, we rebind the IP address. And now come here, comment on the old one, rebind to the LT device. Ctrl O, press Enter, Ctrl X, reload. Okay, now we can click. Before we click, check the temperature. Temperature is 88, change it to DNS temperature. Oops, why is it 10 to 88 again? So this change rate actually is automatically changed by this one. Changed by this one, which means this one worked actually. We will do it later. And you already see it worked. But we want to do the manual attack first, that automatic attack later. So now we can click to see whether it changed to 99. Click, you can see the password is gotten. Right? The password is gotten. You can check the console as well. And you can check here is the address, post. The IP address here, the post method is the address is pointed to the LT device. Check the console here, got a response from the server. Here you see the password. We succeeded. Right, you see it's changed to 99 centigrade. Okay, now you see there is a interruption or intervention is done by this by that automatic change. So that automatic change, please close it in your first task one. Here is an automatic change attack set to. Here is the attack set to, you see. Right, there's an attack set to. Now you see something interesting. The attack set to, because currently it's banned to the LT device, right? On the user side, if they try to access the attack set to, it get the thermometer view just like this. See the LT set to identical. The reason is the attack set to now is banned to. Here bind to the LT device. See here. It's not that automatic attack as you see in task one. So please remember once you checked task one, please close it, which means here. Labs are up. Once you open that. Open this one. In the test, please close it. That one is you saw at the beginning. Here the countdown. Now, because its IP address is the LT device, we will not be able to see that countdown. We need to reband to see that countdown. This time we want to launch the attack automatically. As you saw, that attack succeeded several times, that automatic attack. Before the attack, we bind it to the attacker's machine. Ctrl O, press Enter, Ctrl X, reload. Okay, it's reloaded. Now you refresh, you will see that countdown. But before that, let's check the temperature. Here's the temperature, we change it to a nice temperature. Okay, anyway. Now, we go to the attacksettle.com and refresh. You see this countdown. Do it quickly. Go back here. Oops, I don't have the time now. You're still talking to me, the attacker. Need to talk to the IoT device. So the automatic attack, it will change the temperature to 88. And you see here, it's not changed to 88. It's okay now, let's go ahead and modify it. Because currently it's on the user's machine. The malicious code is downloaded to the user machine, so we need to rebind. Come here, delete, Ctrl O, press Enter, Ctrl X, quit, reload. It's reloaded. Now, 3, 2, 1. Now you are talking to the IoT server, and you can check the IoT server is changing to 88 degrees. So no hurry. You just let it count down. If we missed, it's okay. Now you keep talking to the IoT device because the malicious code will keep running every 10 seconds. So here you see 0, 1. Now it changed to 88. You will change to some other values. Then after fail, when the time is up, 2, 1, 0. You see it changed to 88 again. So it keep attacking this IoT device. 3, 4, 1. You can check the always check the IP address. At the beginning, I didn't create the arrow. Click the arrow. So please click the arrow and the IP address. Okay, that's it. I think we've done the lab. Task 3, to do it automatically with this web page. It'll come down, right? Come down from 10 to 0, and you will set it to 88 Celsius. We wanted to get it 88.